All right, Colt, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go up there, I'm gonna set a rope. I want you to tie on the other rope and a pulley and that whoopee sling, which is that orange thing over yonder. That's what's gonna hold on the pulley.
You'll have to tell me how to do it, but all right.
And I'm hoping the one pulley's gonna be enough, you know? We might have to hook it to the truck or something, like.
Back it down slow?
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, let's get it. God, it's so dangerous. That's really high. I'm not really a big height person, so I don't want to go up there at all. But Josh he's hanging off of it, and he loves it. He's an adrenaline junkie.
All right, Colt. Yeah. So I'm gonna pull this rope up.
Yeah.
And send her back down the side of the tree.
Okay.
I want you to take that pulley over there and hook it through the eye and tie it on.
What do you mean tie it on?
Tie it on the rope so I can pull it up from there.
Just tie it so you can get to it?
See that silver thing?
Yeah.
That's a block and tackle. I want you to hook that in that metal ring. All right. Now, at the bottom of the tree, tie a little loop and just hook the carabiner in it.
All right, you got it.
It's time to lower the furnace into place. I'm gonna put a block of tackle in the tree, run a rope through it, attach it to the furnace, and run the other end of it to the truck.
I got it. Wow, bro, really?
All we gotta do is just hook it to the truck and we'll pull it right up there.
Yeah. You good?
Slow, slow. Sometimes Colt and I got a different way of doing things. He's kind of a wild child, you know, he's a rock star. He can be a little bit impatient. Come help me! But Colt's got a good heart, you know, he works really hard. Heavy. I'm proud to have him as a partner. I don't think I could do all the work myself. Oh. Easy on that, that's precious goods. So basically all we gotta do is level this thing out a little bit, put the steel pot in, put our thump keg in, finish our worm, and we got a steel sight.
Sounds great. Hey, we good?
We're about to turn water into shine.
In North Carolina, Josh and Colt set out to put the final touches on Josh's long-awaited still sight ahead of its inaugural run.
We got a killer worm we're gonna build. It's plexiglass, clear as a dang car window. It's gonna be really badass.
Whew, what do you think, buddy?
I think this is bad to the damn bones, what I think. We're just about there, bro. We just gotta get it all rigged up. To be able to hook all this up, everything has to match up. You gotta make everything fit perfect like it's meant to be there. We'll put the 2-inch pipe on it. Put a 90 on it, 90 it right over to there, and then we'll reduce it from the 2-inch to the 1.5 inch right on.
Right into the coil.
Ching, right there. The furnace has to be in place at a certain height, then the thump keg has to be at a certain place. Same thing with the worm. Think it's gonna fit?
God, I hope so. Come on up.
Lean backwards. All right, easy my arm.
All right, Lego.
This is my idea. I've never seen a clear worm bale ever. I wanted something different. I wanted something super cool. Ah, dog, I love it.
Look how pretty that is. That's an accomplishment.
Ah, damn, that's killer. Feels pretty good to be back in action. So from center to center is about 13 inches. We need some blocks under here. I want to take the block out from underneath there.
Okay.
I want to put them under here.
All right.
And I want to cut the telephone poles, slide 4 telephone poles up underneath this thing, and to keep it from rolling, we'll just nail one of those boards across it.
All right.
We're on a serious time crunch right now, and we don't have any cinder blocks to set it on. All we got is some damn telephone poles, so we're gonna cut them to length, slide them under there, and let it rock and roll. All right. We're almost done, dog. After the season I've had, it feels pretty good to be able to be out here after breaking my back and getting such a late start and then having so much work building a steel sight. I didn't want to cut any corners. I wanted to build a steel sight that I could stay in and be proud of. That's it right there, man. All right, if my calculations are right, which they never are, it's a little off.
Ugh.
There we go, right there.
Look at that. Look at that.
Oh, we got a steel sight, bro.
Feels really good to be ready to run after having such a hard start to my season. I've got something here that I can always have here that I can always come back to.
Steel's ready. All we got to do is bowl this thing out, cook her down. We got shine, man. Are you excited?
I'm really excited, man.
Today's our first run on this steel sight.
Then I got to go on tour.
In North Carolina, it's down to the wire as Josh and Colt rush to fill a 60-gallon order for Colt's band, the Moonshine Bandits.
The only way we're going to be able to get our 60 gallons to your band on time is if we do two back-to-back runs.
We'll make it. That'll be enough to get there in time, though, won't it?
Yeah. After all this work, today's the day. I mean, we're down to the wire. Colt's got to leave to go on tour. I'd like to find out if we got any bugs in this thing before we try to run, but we don't have any choice. We just got to have to make it and make it work. Hell yeah. I've been dying for this part. I invent stuff, you know. I'm always trying to think outside the box and think of things that other people aren't. I just wanted something that nobody else has ever done before. Just wanted something cool, you know what I mean? Boom. This furnace can be wood-fired or it can be propane-fired. Today, I'm gonna be able to use propane to heat this. We're cooking now.
Slid right in like a dream. Now what?
It's a waiting game.
Yeah?
Grab you a seat, I reckon.
This is what you gotta use in the woods. Probably too loud for moonshine in the woods, ain't it?
Yeah. Everybody in the country gonna know we're here.
Well, that's what you do when you're bored and you make a moonshine. We're creeping.
Oh, we're getting close, man.
Yeah?
Yeah, we're right in here.
All right. Josh, what is that coming out of that pot?
Damn it. That's just water, it ain't liquid. Remember when we was gonna solder this stupid thing here in there?
Yeah.
Well, we forgot to damn take it apart and solder it, and so that whole thing is leaking at that elbow right there. So all this is water. We dry fit the worm when we put it together, and we didn't go back and solder it. We forgot all about that because we got so in such a rush to try to get done, then it's coming out the worm. Looks like moonshine, but it ain't. Please turn the gas off. It has to be drained out and soldered. It's the only thing we can do.
You know I gotta leave tomorrow. This ain't gonna make the quota. We're gonna be.
Oh no, we'll get it. To get this soldered, you know, it's kind of in a predicament. When you're under a deadline, I mean, you're gonna be under the pressure. You're gonna have to work fast. It's fixable, but it's gonna take a little time. Something I don't really have a whole lot of right now.
Wipe it off the bottom. That's ruined. You ripped it off. Look. Yeah, that's the proper word for this.
Damn, I got a headache from hell. In between the plexiglass and where the worm comes together, if there's no seal there, it's gonna be pissing water out faster than we can pour it in. And my worst nightmare was breaking that seal, and it happened. It takes about 12 hours or something for that silicone to seal on there.
I won't be here. I want to miss the run, man. I'm gonna be on tour. I gotta leave tomorrow morning, no doubt. No choice.
Been under such a tremendous amount of pressure trying to get this done.
We still got 60 gallons to deliver, so it's all on you now.
My worst nightmare came true. Colt's leaving me, cuz can't be here to help me. I'm gonna have to finish it myself, and I'm gonna have to haul it myself. I'm gonna have to make sure it gets there without anybody's help, cause all I got right now is me. All you gotta do is tell them guys that we're making it, we're in the process of it, and you had to skin out, and that I'm on my way with it. I don't know how I'll get it to you, but I'll get it to you. I'll make it happen, trust me.
Got to.